to the front.
We are in the
fifth sarga of this Balakand. In the four sargas, what we have seen so far, that Sri Valmiki Rishi was given a great boon, a great blessing by Lord Brahma himself, and he had become the seer of the story of Ramayana. It is very interesting to note that in the very beginning of Ramayana, the end is indicated. In the last sarga we saw, Sri Rama listened to this story from his own sons. This is very interesting that commentators here are saying, how is that beginning of the story is about end of the story? That this is going to be narrated by the sons of Rama, Dago, Lava and Kusha, and he will listen to it, his own story. So while writing the Ramayana beginning itself, how is that Sri Ram Valmiki knew that what is going to happen? Either there are two possibilities. Either this is added later. That is not acceptable because Ramayana is said to be itihasa. Itihasa means iti asau. This is how it was. So it is, if it is this is how it was, then how is that you put end before the beginning? So that means you, it's a story you wrote afterwards. Then it is not itihasa. It's only literature. Or a history later on accounted by Valmiki. Or we have to say that it is added by somebody else later on. Then Valmiki cannot be considered as one who wrote all the 24,000 verses. The only possibility is that Valmiki Rishi had foresightedness. They are called Kavi, and the meaning of Kavi is Kranta Darshi. Those who have Vikala Jnana, they know all the three periods of time. We are not able to do that because our mind is most of the time occupied with the past. Swamiji, I did this. Swamiji, I did that. Ayo, I did that. Ayo, I did this. Or we are worried about what is going to happen in the future. I don't know. This country is going to dogs. Everybody is going to dogs. Nobody going to God. Some other complain like this all the time. So people who are either buried in their past and worried in the future, they cannot be having the Kranta Darshitvam. Kavis are, they are able to gain the grace of the Lord because they are able to live in the moment and gain that blessings from the Lord. So he was given that great grace that you will be able to not only see what is happening, but also know what everybody is thinking. Darshitvam cha prakashitvam cha. Seeing as well as knowing what is happening. So therefore we should conclude that it is Valmiki Rishi knew that this is how it is going to end, and this is how it is going to be narrated by his own sons, Lava. So in the Panchama Sarga, it is about the greatness of the city called Ayodhya. Manu Nirmita Kosala Janapada Andarvarti Ayodhyayaha Varnanam. Ayodhyayaha Varnanam. Varnanam, description. Varna in Sanskrit means color, quality, features. Varnana, description, is none other than explaining quality, features of a thing. So, Varnana, description of Ayodhya. Ayodhya, the great city. It is interesting, somebody gave me a book called Lost Cities. picture, what you call, photo book. In that, the capital of Thailand in the past was known as Ayodhya. And even today, the king is always referred as Ram. Rama 1, Rama 2, Rama 3. Not in India, huh? In Thailand. In India, nobody bothered about it. That's the ancient city, Ayodhya. Yodhum na shakyate iti Ayodhya. Nobody can win, inconquerable city. So that was the capital of Koshala Nagari, Koshala Desha. So Koshala Janapada, Koshala Nagara, Antarvarti, that which is within Ayodhya Nagari, Ayodhyaya Varnanam. And who established this city? Manu Nirmita. It was Manu, the first human king. He established this great city. It's so ancient. In the fourth chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, O Arjuna, I am giving you this high, great knowledge, Karma Yoga. This is not new. This is not today I am giving it to you. It was given to Lord Sun in the beginning of the universe. Imam Vivasvate Yogam Proktavanaham Avyayam Vivasvan Manave Praha Manurikshvakave Bhavid. This Imam Yogam, this knowledge, Proktavanaham, Vivasvan Proktavanam, Vivasvan, that is Surya. Proktavan, I spoke about it. Avyayam Yogam, imperishable knowledge. Vivasvan Manave Praha. Vivasvan, the sun gave to Manu, the first king. That's why it's called human. Man, this may man hai or human. One who has man, because animals, they do not use even though they have. So Manu, because he has used man, the first human. Vivasvan Manave Praha, to Manu he gave, son, Lord Sun imparted this knowledge to Manu. Manuhu Ikshvakave Abravi. Ikshvaku Vamsha, the king of the first Ikshvaku Parampara is Ikshvaku. Ikshvaku means Iksham, the word is divided into Iksh and Aka, Akaroti. Ikshu means Icham Akaroti. Icham Akaroti, one who fulfills all the wishes. It's called Ikshvaku. And Sri Rama is from that dynasty. Therefore, Sri Rama belongs to the Sun dynasty. Surya Vamsha. Because Surya was the first, gave it to Manu. Manu gave to Ikshvaku. Devam Parampara Praptam Imam Rajashrayo Viduhu. This knowledge that I gave to you, all the Rajarishis know it, including Dasharatha. Sakalena Mahata Yogo Nashtam Parantava. But in due course of time, because it was not practiced properly, so it lost its greatness. Therefore, I have to tell you again. So, this Ayodhya was the great, inconquerable, insurmountable, great city. So, here we begin verse number first, that is your page number in this book. I don't know which. Sarva Purvamiyam Yesham Asi Krishna Vasundhara Prajapatim Upadaya Rupanam Jayashalinam Yesham Sagaro Nama Sagaro Yena Khanita Shashti Putra Sahasrani Yam Yam Tam Paryavarayan Ikshvakunamidam Tesham Rajyam Vamse Mahatmanam Mahakutpanna Makyanam Ramayanami Visrutam Taditam Vartayishyavaha Sarvam Nikilamatitaha Dharma Kamartha Sahitam Srotavyam Manusuyata. Srotavyam Manasuyata Idam Kavyam. This great literature to be listened to by those who do not have the bad quality of finding fault with others. Anasuya. Asu. Asuyan. Thinking of what is wrong with others all the time. Anasuya. Atri Maharshi's wife is known as Anasuya. Why it is so? It's very symbolic. Atri means one who has gone beyond the three gunas. Only such a person will have the quality of anasuyatva. So anasuya means not having the mind constantly worrying or thinking about what is wrong, what is wrong, what is wrong. So one who has crossed the three qualities of the prakriti alone can be like that. So it's, symbolically it is his wife. And for them born Datta Atreya. Datta Atreya. Atreya Maharishi. Atri Maharishi's son. Therefore Datta Atri. Datta Atri. Datta Atreya. So the incarnation of Vishnu, Shiva and Brahma together. They are considered by many parts of India as representative of Guru Parampara. All the three. Anyway. So anasuyata, anasuyata idam kavyam shrotavyam to be heard. And what is, this is sung by whom? Lava and Kusha. They are saying this to be heard, Ramayanam idam kavyam anasuyata shrotavyam. So where is this Ramayana Katha coming from? So starting from the Ayodhya. Because the city has to be, or the place where it all happened, began, the story has to begin, that the story begins with. You know, when you see any Hollywood movie, this is an aerial view, and go on, and then finally they come to one home, small home. First they will have to start with, you know, the global view. Now see the global view. Sarva purvam yam yesham. Sarva, this globe, this earth. This earth is considered to be of having seven dvipas. Sapta dvipa vasundara. Sapta dvipa. They have understood there were seven dvipas. Seven islands. Now we call it as seven continents. Jambu dvipa, Plaksha dvipa, Salmani dvipa, Kusha dvipa, Krauncha dvipa, Shakadvipa, Pushkaradvipa, it is Saptadvipa. In that, Jambudvipa is Bharata. That is Asia. Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Australia, Europe, Oceania. So the seven continents. Sarva Purvamiyam Yesha. All these, the entire globe, the earth, entirely Krishna Yam Vasundara. This earth, Vasundara, Prajapatim Upadaya, starting from Prajapati, Prajanampati, from the creator onwards, including all the descendants Manu, Yesham Rupanam Jayashalinam Purvam Asi. This was conquered and ruled by the great successful people. Esham Rupanam Jayashalina. Those who are very successful kings, victorious ones, they have conquered and then ruled this whole earth. Which means all the seven continents were ruled by the great descendants of Prajapati. That is how it all started. Yesham sasagaro nama sagaro yena kanitaha. In that descendants there was a king called Sagara. And what is his contribution? He dug a huge well, which from where the water has collected so much. And therefore, Sagara Sagara iti kathyate. Why ocean is called Sagara? It's because it was dug by Yesham sa sagaro nama sagaro yena khanitaha. Khanitaha, it is dug by him. And he had 60,000 sons. Shashti putra sahasrani yamyantam paryavarayan. So he had 60,000 sons who were with him when he went for a war. Meaning he had almost, you know, imagine 60,000. Obviously, Prajapati created the environment, so his son will be at least that much. He must have that many sons. Prajapati is the father of everybody. So, Yesham Sagaraha Yena Kanitaha Yantam Yam Shashti Sahaputra Sahasrani Padyavaryan Parida Agapshan Saha Sagaro Nama Sagaro Nama. The king was known as Sagara. We'll see about him little later, what happened afterwards. Now, this dynasty is known as Ikshvaku. I told you what is the meaning of that. Ikshvaku nam idam tesam rajyam mamshe mahatmana. In this very great dynasty, tesam Ikshvaku nam ikshum ikshaam akarodi idi Ikshvaku. Rajyam Vamshe, in this very race, idam Ramayanam iti shrutam kavyam mahat utpannam, mahat pujaniyam utpannam akhyam. This great epic known as Ramayana was created. And it is not any human creation. Brahmana prasadad utpannam. It is because of the grace of Lord Brahma. Nobody else can take credit. And that is why Valmiki Rishi does not say it is my creation. Brahmanaha tatra nimitta matram aham idi vinaya uktihi. He says, I am nimitta matram. I am only an instrument in the hands of Brahma who wanted this to be narrated. I am only a narrator. I cannot take credit for this great kavyam. Because I am just reporting the greatness of a great individual. So therefore, he doesn't claim to be the author, but he claimed to be one who has seen and described for the benefit of the posterity. So, idasya atra varnaniyasya nayakasya sarva apurvam iti anena mahavagyatvam nama gunaha vukta. It is because of the greatness of the nayaka, the hero of this great story. Great story. And therefore it is greatness of the great personality that makes this whole kavya very great. Brahmana prasada deva utpannatve tavakkim krityam. What is your contribution here? If anybody asks Valmiki, he says, tadidam vartayishyavaha sarvam nikilamatitaha. Dharmakamartasagitam srotavyam manasuyata. I am narrating this story for only one purpose. See, any kavya or any text you take, there are four things you should know. Anubandha Chatushtaya is called. Adhikari, Vishaya, Sambandha and Prayojanam. Who is the person who has to listen to? Who is qualified for that? And what is the subject matter? What is the result? And how is it connected? So here, who is the person who can listen to this? Anasuyata Shrotavyam. One who is mentally very clean. One who does not look for what's wrong and what is the defect everywhere in this world. Because there is always some something or the other in this world. We can toast anybody, but we don't, do not mean it. So we can go on cursing others and making mockery of us, but you know, one should not make that as one's own lifestyle. One should not make one's my life miserable by just keeping on cursing others. So the anusuyata shrotavyam. What is the subject matter here? Subject matter is that moksha only. Dharma kamartha sahitam shrotavyam. He says that this moksha is not away from worldly life. Somebody asked me the definition of what is renunciation. I said simple, the definition of renunciation is total acceptance. It is not running away, it is not walking away, but it is accepting the imperfection. That is what we have to shed. What we have to let go? Intolerance of imperfection. Intolerance of others, which are other than oneself also. The imperfections that we all possess. And we are brooding over that, we can never be able to renounce. That is what we have to renounce actually. Raga dvesha. So here, dharma kamartha sahitam moksham is the vishaya. Vishaya, the subject matter is not just renunciation. Then it is the Upanishad then. If it is only about moksha. No, it is not about moksha alone, but along with dharma kama artha sahita. Along with the knowing what is the virtue to be followed, how to gain wealth in this very world, how to enjoy that pleasure, wealth also properly, and leading oneself to moksha. So that is the vishaya. Sambandha, let us see, what is the result of that? The result of this is that one gains the dharma artha kama. The Shrota, the one who is listener, will gain this as his prayojana, moksha prayojana. So therefore it is becoming a most important text for all people who are grihastaha, because they have to engage in, you know, worldly things, and how well one should engage in that is demonstrated by the Lord. Continuing. Kosalo nama mutitah, spito janapato mahan, nivishta sarayutire, prabhuta danadhanyavan, ayodhya nama nagari, tatrasil loka visruta manuna manavendrena yapuri nirmita swayam. Kosalo nama, named as Kosala. Some people say Kosala. If it is Kosala, then it is from root word Kushalata. Kushalata. Kushala means welfare. In Tamil they say Kushalam Sharikal. Meaning how are you? Are you well? Are you in the well or in, out of the well? That is called Kushala. So, Kosala. A great prosperous country. Understand? Bharatavarsha or this India, earlier it was nothing but various countries in one particular continent. Like Africa, if you say, there are many, various countries are there, together they are. Land by there, they may not be, politically they are not together. Similarly, at that time, Bharatavarsha was none other than the collection of many, many countries. The prominent one was Kosala Desha. Kosalo nam prabhuta dana danyavan, abundance of dana and danyam. Dana, well, danyam, food grains. One should recognize this very clearly. when you say a country, when you say, it is nothing but collection of people living together as a culture. And most of the culture what we find in this world developed in the banks of rivers, not on the banks of ocean or sea, rivers. Why it is so? Life is sustained by that water, and all living beings want that. And great cultures developed in the past only at the banks of rivers. Sarayu is considered as one of the tributaries coming from Himalayas. Another story that is what we find in Mahabharata is that this particular Anushasana Parva, this particular Sarayu river was none other than Ganges itself. It is said once Vasishtha Mahamuni was going towards in the Himalayas, walking, and the Ganges was going towards Manasarovar. And he stopped it. From where he stopped, it took a turn and moved ahead, and that is why it is called. That is the river known as Sarayu. So this Sarayu Tire, there, this great city or the great country was at the having the Ayodhya was at the banks of Ayodhya, the banks of Sarayu Tirtha. But this country was pretty much having the lifeline of Sarayu, because the water alone has made the culture flourish. And it is also found that when Sri Bhagavan, Sri Rama, when he completed his avatar, he ascended to Vaikuntha by drowning himself in the Sarayu. He himself, as well as Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna, all of them went into that. So that is the holiness of this great river. So now here we see, in this country, Prabhudadanadanyavan Koshalo Nama Muditaha, people were lived with great contentment, joy, Sphitaha, prosperous, Mahan Vistirnaha, it's a vast country, Janapadaha, Sarayutire Nibishtaha, it was situated in that place. Coming back to the point as a culture, people when they live together, they have to adjust, obviously. When you start living together, then you have to find the sustenance, the food, etc., from the place where only you are living. If you are a hunter and you are going from place to place, because animals keep moving according to the season, etc., then you keep moving. Then you are also a, like a gypsy, keep moving. And such a group of community can never be a culture. They are only vultures. Where the water is there the life is there the culture is there the people live together, adjusting with each other, and then coming to have the development of art, music and dance and architecture, sculptures, literature, knowledge, understanding, vision, all those things will happen. Where the people are constantly moving, they are only fighting with each other. Even today, such kind of culture, if you don't believe me, if you don't adjust with me, if you don't believe what I believe, I will kill you. That is called desert culture. They do not have the culture of adjustment, tolerance. Because only when you live together, you have to adjust. When I keep going, why should I adjust? If you are traveling in a flight, and you don't need to adjust with the other fellow. But you are living with this person forever in your life. One man was praying to God. I told you this, I think. Instead of I put it in a different way. He was praying to God. God appeared. Yes. He said, you are made girls, women, so beautiful, so intelligent, so bright, so nice. But why wives are so angry, upset, shouting all the time? God smiled. I made the girls, you made the wives. So it is your problem, not mine. I don't know what is right and what is wrong, but this is what I heard. So, adjustment, that is what is called life is. And if you are going to live, like when we went to this yatra, etc., you have to adjust. In the room, they have 3-4 people. You have to adjust. Right? Then only there is a possibility that the journey will be comfortable. So, a culture necessarily demands sacrifice. And there, that's what is called evolvement of that particular community. The community living all the time with the gun in the hand, how can there be any sacrifice? If you don't listen to me, I'll kill you. So what we find is, this Ayodhya Nagar will show you what the culture was. Now you understand how the culture developed. Ayodhya nama nagari tatra atit loka visruta. Tatra, there in that Kosala nagara, Kosala country, desha, ya puri, which city, manavendrena manuna swayam nirmita. Manava indrena, the great king called Manu, manava indrena manuna swayam nirmita, by himself established. And it is said sankalpa matre. Is mere thought of it. Ayodhya nama, the named Ayodhya, Loka Vishruta, Loke Vishruta, very well known in this world, famous, Nagari Asir, Ayodhya Nagari Asir, there was a city called Ayodhya. Ayata Dasha Chadve, Ayata Dasha Chadve, Yojanani Mahapuri Srimati Trini Vistirna Suvibhakta Mahapata Rajamargena Mahata Suvibhaktena Shobita Mukta Pushpava Kirnena Jala Siktena Nityasaha Kamtu Raja Dasarato Maharashtra Vivardhanaha Purima Vatayamasa Divideva Patiryata Kapata Toranavatim Suvibhaktantarayana Suvibhaktantarapana Sarvayantra Yudavatim Ushitam Sarvashilpibihi. Now, this Ayodhya Nagara, you know, today we find a big city means what? Tall buildings and a broad, beautiful roads, 4-lane, 6-lane, 8-lane. Those times, they had huge roads where the chariots have to go. War, when the war comes, all the elephants and all have to go. It cannot be a small lane. It must be 10-lane. Both sides. That's why I say that. Ayata Dasachatve Mahapuri, this Ayodhya Nagari. Srimati, beautiful. Suvibhakta Mahapata, well laid out, very beautifully. Laid out the roads with the trees both sides. Dashachatvecha yojanani ayata. In length, ayata. Dashacha dve. 12 yojanas. Dashacha dve. 10 plus 2. Yojana, your own yojana is 8 miles. So there are, that is 12 into 8, 36 miles, I mean, sorry, 12 into 8, 96 miles in length, and Trini Yojanani Vistirna. The particular Ayodhya Nagar had 36 miles in length and 24 miles in width. So that is the dimension of that city. Rajamargena Mahata Suvibhaktena Sovita. It is Suvibhaktena. It is well divided into two parts. And Rajamarga, it's a royal path. Mukta Pushpava Kirnena. It's beautiful. It is, both sides were filled with flowers. Mukta Pushpa. Mukta Pushpava Kirnena. Spread out with flowers, and they didn't have sprinkler system there. They may have had, we don't even know. Therefore, Nityasaha Jalasiktena. Every day they were watered. All the soldiers were there to make sure that both sides of the land, the roads were filled with flowers and constantly being watered. Mahada Rajamargena Sobita. This is a physical description of the beautiful city of Ayodhya. Devapatihi Divamyata Tam Purim Maharashtra Vivardhanaha Raja Jasaratha Avasayamasa. That very city, Tampurim, Raja Dasharatha. Dasharatha was the king who was ruling that beautiful kingdom. Devapati Divamyata. Just like Devapati, that is Indra, just like he rules heavens. You know, after all, what is the heaven there? Where everything is available if you work hard. In the Deva, you work hard here and you will be available there. But if there is a place where you work hard, you get it directly there itself. You don't need to wait to go to heaven. So many people say that we work hard and then we'll go to heaven and enjoy. What's the point? You don't even know. Why not have it here itself? So, a country where we can work, one can work hard and get the benefit and the blessings, one there itself, then it is for them. Is it not true? So, Ayodhya was such kind of a great city where people were full of joy, and because they had all the comfort and conveniences and facilities available to them with a very virtuous leader or king, Dasharatha. Devam dasvitam to Raja Dasharato Maharashtra Vivardhana. And he continuously engaged in expanding his country. Vivardhana. Not the physical part, but his rulership. Vardhana means to increase, to grow. Vivardhana. Maharashtra Vivardhana. He is constantly engaged in spreading his wings into the administration to larger and larger areas. Purim Avayas Avasayamasa. He lived in that country. In that particular city, Divi Deva Patirikata, just like Indra was doing there. Kapata Toranavatim Suvibhaktantarapanam. Kapata means the gate. What do you call that? Gateway to the city. Like we have Gateway of India. Toranavati. It is like a beautiful architecture. The entry point to the city was so beautiful, and that itself shows a culture which has become prosperous is seen in the way their architectures were. Because people had time to relish and increase their vision of beauty. Nowadays, this tall, tall structure and everything is already pre-assembled and tuck, 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 done. So our concept of living has changed so dramatically nowadays. Don't worry about anything else. But imagine those people of the past who worked so hard to make everything so beautiful because they had a vision about the posterity. The future, they thought about it. Okay, the buildings were not meant for today and tomorrow's purpose. It has to stay for hundreds of years. It has to stay and become a monument for the culture that was there. Right? So they had spent, the kings spent a lot of time in making such beautiful structures and encouraged people to do that. Then you should understand the culture was here to stay. Right? If you are running all the time, you know, you don't know tomorrow will be there, why should you bother about it? So today we find there's such a lack of interest in such kind of architecture, such kind of beauty and art. Because why? Tomorrow we work is dead. That the ability to pay attention to simple things and making it beautiful is not. Kapata toranavatim suvibhaktantara apana. Apana. Pana means money. Apana means where the commerce of money transaction takes place. That's called a shop. Commercial traders, I mean trading places. So, as soon as you enter the city, both sides, suvi bhaktantara apana, both sides you will find a lot of shops and merchandise everywhere. Sarvayan and so, all the commercial transactions were taking place in that city, and at the same time, the city is not vulnerable. It is extremely protected, ready for a fight, and nobody can dare conquer this because sarva yantra ayudavadim, it had all the latest missiles and all the equipments or armory. Sarva yantra, yantra means machinery. I might have told you this about this particular word. Trutrayate, the word tru means to transcend, to cross, to move away, and to come over. That is the word, tr. That's in English also transport, transcend, travel, tra. It's the original Sanskrit word tr. Traverse, translate. What is that? Tr means to cross, to convert. From place, from move one point to another point, when you change, it's called tr. Tra. Trayate, taranam. So when it is by the mind when you do it, it's called mantra. Mind is used for moving from one point of attention to, or one point of mind perception to another point. From one level of understanding to another level of understanding. It's called mantra. Through the mind when you do it, it's called mantra. Through your body when you do it, meaning you do an action which is meant for you to move from one level of consciousness to another level of consciousness, tanuna trayate iti tantra. Tanuna kayena sharira, by sharira from the body. So this technique of tantra, which is developed in India, is where an individual can will go to different level of consciousness by some physical action. And if you find in Kerala and etc. we go, most of the pujas are performed with no words. In the southern part of India, with Tamil Nadu, etc., or Andhra, or Karnataka, if you go, the priests would be chanting most of the mantras. You will listen to that. But if you go to a typical Kerala temple, you would go to Guruvayur or Shabarimala or any other place you go, Nambudri will not say a word. But he will be doing all hand symbols, invoking the powers, energy through his hand movements, and with his mind focusing on it. It's called tantra. So usually it is used in a very wrong connotation, which is not right, which is not proper. He is himself known as Santri one. Santri means priest. Mantri, I don't know what to call them. Not ministers, not sinister, we are not talking. Mantri also one who utters mantras. Now, with the equipments when you do, it's called yantra. Yam. Yantra. With the physical equipment, not the body, not the mind, but like with this is a yantra. When you calculate it, that's calculator is a yantra. It's a vehicle, that is a yantra. Because nowadays we are in the yantra loka. We are not in tantra loka or mantra loka. We are only yantra loka. Because we totally depend upon only yantras. Anything we have to do, communication is through yantra. And then talking is, driving is through yantra. And then everything is through yantra. Writing is yantra. Nowadays nobody writes in Thailand. That is yantra. So, during those times, they did have the equipments well, well manufactured, very well equipped with the armory, that is well. Sarva yantra ayudavatim, this nagari, because nagari being feminine, that's why. Sarva yantra ayudavatim nagarim. Ushitam sarva shilpi bihi. Ushitam dwelled by sarva shilpi bihi, various people of great skills. Shilpi means one who is an architect or a sculptor. So they were using all various equipments and then made the whole city so beautiful, and also it had various armors, various missiles, etc. Now, that is about the physical part of the city. Now, we'll come to the beauty of it. Verse number 11 onwards. Sutamagada sambadham Srimati matula prabham Ucchatala dvajavadim Shatagni Shatasankulam Vadunataka Sangaischa Sangyuktam Sarvatapurim Udhyanam Ravanopetam Mahatim Salamekalam Durgambira parikam Durgamanye durasatam Vajivarana sampurnam Govirushtai karestata Samantaraja Sangaischa Balikarma Viravradam Nana Desa Nivasaischa Vanikbhihi Upashopitam Prasadai Sratna Vikrutaihi Parvatairiva Shobitam Kutagaraischa Sampurnam Indrasyeva Maravatim. Now the king, who is thus an excellent administrator, always is praised by various people. You may have seen Raja Raja Martanda Raja Bodanda Raja, they will go on talking about and with the whole Vamsha and then para. So it is the glory of the king is sung. So in this way, there are people who are singing these such songs in the temples, at the palaces, and they are nartakis, various other. Vadu nataka sangaischa. Vadu means those nartayitaraha, all those people who are singers. Nataka sangaischa, all various dramatic drama people or players, those who are belong to that Hollywood category. They're all there. Samyuktam, Sarvatapurim, everywhere. So the city had not only the beautiful architecture, but artists, singers, dancers, and dramatists, all of them. Samyuktam, Sarvatapurim, Udhyana, Amravanopetam. Udhyana, Udhyana garden. Various beautiful gardens, Amravana, mango groves, Upetam, endowed with. So that means food, gardens, beauty of trees, forests, groves, Salamekalam, and the Mekala means like a girdle. Girdle, what do you call that? Girdle, girdle. This is like a person who wears, during the dance they wear, what is it called? Uddiyana. What do you call them? Belt. English called belt, but that belt is. In that same way, the tree called Sala, the tree was acting as a barricade all around the country, all around the city, the form of a thick growth. It's such a beautiful, you know, landscape that you can see there. Durga Gambira Parikam. And at the same time, to save, to keep the city very safe, what they have done, they built the walls all around the city and dug huge wells next to it. Durga Gambira Parika means the wells, the trenches. So unless there is a bridge, you cannot enter that place, and then they remove it. All the time it is removed. Only when the king or somebody has to go out, it is laid out. Go and then again it is removed. So nobody can get in. So that requires a lot of maintenance, and then Durga Gambira Parikam. Deep trenches are over. Durgam Manni Turatadam. Very difficult by others to enter into that city. Vajivarana Sampurnam. So the army had Vaji filled with horses. Varana. That is elephants. So all various such, and then tada govihi by the cattle, pushtaihi by camels, karaihi by mules. Everybody had experience of the mule, anyway. Mules, horses, cows, and elephants, all of them were there. But to transport people for the army to move around, so many of them were there. Samantaraja Sangaischa. And Samantara means the neighboring kings were all coming, and they were all coming in great numbers into the city. Bali karma viravrutam. Bali karma karma bihi. Because they were to pay taxes to this king. Who is the samrat? Who is the chakravarti? He had conquered the neighboring countries, and if they were to exist, they have to pay tax. IRS. They have to pay taxes to the king. Otherwise, they will not be allowed to stay there. And they will, if you are not paying taxes, we will conquer your country and bring it to ourselves. So all the various kings, on a daily basis, they were all coming in large numbers to pay taxes. Bali karma bihi. Avrutam. And Nana Desha Nivasaischa Vanigbihi Upashobitam. And various merchants from other countries were all assembled there to do the merchandise and to do all the transactions. So it was such a busy city with full of activity there. Prosperity was plenty, and then all of them had so many activities going on, extremely well protected, and with all the equipments, etc. Such a city was Ayodhya. Prasadai Ratna Vigrudaihi. Parasa, that means palaces. Ratna Vigridayi. It stuttered with gems. Why do you think so many Angrasas came into India? If it is a poor country. They had precious stones everywhere. Gold, everything. See, they did not have the idea that gold is something which is to be a transactional property. It is for beauty. It is not valued in terms of money. It is valued in terms of beauty. So if you go to many of the temples, you will find that it's gold covered or the inside the what you call, Garbhagraha is full of, we saw in one of the temples. What is that place? Remember we went?
Bhaktap.
So Nepal was not under the rule of British. It was king, right? And we find some of the temples have got the entire door and the doorway inside the Garbhagraha. Everything is gold. Nothing is touched. It's not neither Islam, it's Muslim invaders or the British, European invaders ever took away anything from there. Because this is the temple of the king. So still today, it is all gold. So, but that is not considered in terms of money. It's considered as beauty. Ratna vikrutaihi prasadaihi parvadeeriva shobita. And when the sunlight falls on it, it looks like a resplendent, beautiful mountain. Bright and beautifully shining there. Kutagaraischa sampurnam indrasya eva gambhira gambhira. Kutagara. So it is huge mansions, sampurnam completely, indrasya amaravati eva. Like that of the indrasya amaravati. This is that like that of the amaravati, the capital of Indra. In that way it is so beautifully shining there. So that is the description of Uchatala Dvajavatim. We saw that before. And I think verse number 11 that we skipped there. Suta Madhana Samvad Srimadim Atula Prabham, incomparable beauty. Uchatala Dvajavatim. In every house or every mansion there was a flag of that country. When we were in Tibet, we saw every house had got Chinese flag. Every house, I'm not even exaggerating. Ask anybody. Why? Because you cannot touch us. This is our place. So in the same way here, Ayodhya, that Dvaja was in every mansion. Tell the world that we are here to stay. Nobody can touch us. So like that. Further the description of the Ayodhya Nagari, and then comes the greatness of the king who was ruling there. Then the story will begin to how the king was, you know, without the progeny, and then he looked for, you know, a means to gain that descendant, and then Rama's thing will start. Om sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve badrani pasyantu, ma kaschit dukha bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti. Hari Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. I have a nice song here if you would like to sing along with me. I had it in the morning. Now it is not there. Tomorrow, it's such a beautiful song.